Well, I'm very fortunate. Mr. Steve Saleen is here, the legendary gentleman who has started arguably the best, you know, individual Mustang manufacturing on his own. More production than the original Shelby's. And
Not included.
I'm here with this beautiful car. I'm just going to turn it over to Steve. He's going to talk about this George Follmer tribute, Saleen.
Stop it.
Well, as you can see, this is our newest addition to what we call the Heritage Collection, and this is the George Follmer edition. Saleen, and obviously it's a tribute and a replica of his 1969 Boss 302 Mustang that he ran in the Trans Am series. And George and Parnelli Jones were teammates that year, and George actually did very well. The particular car won.
Do I hear 250?
Two races at Bridgehampton, New York, and Riverside, California, the last race that particular year. What we've done here is we've recreated in today's style a replication of the car as it was raced back at that point in time. This is the actual picture here, the actual race car that George drove. In that, and this
these
particular one was taken at, I think, Bridgehampton, New York. All of the aerodynamics and everything from the front air dam to the different hood to the front grille have been replicated. Obviously, on the side of the car, you see the replication of the mini light racing wheels that were the rage back then for the aspect of racing. And then in the rear is we've added the ducktail spoiler to mimic 1969 with a different fascia, and down to a lot of the details, like the rear taillights having the chrome bezels around it, which was a very period correct styling. We also then added the sports slats that were a lot of fun, and the shaker hood that was appropriate from the 60s as well, and even appropriate today.
Hey, shut up, I got a show to pay for.
Under the hood, the engine has been changed from basically the heads, valves, valve springs, intake, manifold, camshafts, which allows us to raise the RPM red line by 1,000 higher and give us close to 500 horsepower, which makes us normally aspirated vehicle very, very quick. In fact, it's a lot quicker than I think people would realize on how responsive. It comes with the latest in the racecraft we've developed with it. And then as you go through into the interior of the car, it's pretty cool in the replication in sort of the badging and the feel for the 60s, but in today's terminology with the way we did the pleating on the seats and the replication on those type of aspects. And really, the gauges, the shift knob, all of that has gone down to the detail. But one of the cool details that you probably haven't seen.
Okay, right on.
In the floor mats is that we have the Saleen George Follmer floor mat. But if you flip it over, it actually has the embroidery of the racetracks the car won. This particular embroidery is the Bridgehampton Raceway, and then on the other side is the embroidered Riverside Racetrack.
Wow, that's
so all the attention to detail has been done with this.
And the car has an amazingly aggressive stance. I mean, it's pretty hard to, when you see this thing up close, I mean, it's it looks like it's ready to go on the track right now. It's gorgeous, and the color scheme, which is, as Steve had mentioned, it's, you know, dead on ringer for the original. But look at how low that front air dam is. It's literally almost on the ground, that chin spoiler. And the car looks incredible, just absolutely incredible. And Steve, what's the production run going to be on these?
It's 250 units, because back in the 60s, most of the racing was 250 miles. This particular aspect of it, we're tying into the old Riverside Raceway track, and it was specifically the Mission Bell 250 is what all of our iconic cars ran in 69 and 70. And, so the replication of it is what we attributed for 250 units.
And production will be running through up. This is obviously the 2014, so when the...
Yeah, so we'll start production in late November, December, and we'll run in the first quarter of next year, and then that'll be it. The mold will be broken, thrown away, and you'll have a very collectible piece.
And for those of you that don't know, when they did the Parnelli Jones, they did those, I think there was 500 units for
the
highly collectible. You know, they brought back the Shaker. They're first ones to bring the 302 back, pre-Coyote, and those are very collectible today. And it's great to see Mr. Saleen back with his namesake and running the show again. It's just great. And here's their 302, the Saleen supercharged car.
Yeah, this is just a normal everyday 302.
Yeah, this is just a run-of-the-mill Coyote with probably 600 some horsepower.
But what's important is that we actually have the normally aspirated vehicles now. Price-wise, we're able to, because of our volume now, is have the advantage price to where you can get the 450 normally aspirated for less than $40,000.
Wow.
$39,000. That includes the car. People keep asking, well, what's the car? No, that's out the door.
That's not an addition to, correct?
No, that's everything. And then the supercharged, which is over 600 horsepower, it starts at basically $52,000.
Second place.
And then you can go to the top of the line of car, which is the 351. Which is 750, and that starts at 82,000.
And is that a basically a stroked Coyote 302? Is
no,
it a
no? It's a completely different engine.
Oh, is it really? Wow.
Second place goes to Clarence.
So this is Steve just mentioned. This is the S351.
We've got one member from that club here.
And this is unique to Saleen, putting a 351 cubic inch motor. This is a prototype. It's number one. As he mentioned, this is going to be available at about 80,000. It's in a gorgeous, very eye-popping color, too.
You guys ready for some big-ticket items?